खरे जयकार करे। गोरह के मोदक भोग लगत है, मोषक वाहन चर्या करे। सौम्य रूप सेवा गणपति की, विघ्न भाग जा दूर परे। भादो मास शुक्ल चतुर्थी, दिन दो पहरा पूरा परे। लियो जन्म गणपति प्रभु जी, दुर्गा मन आनंद भरे। श्री शंकर को आनंद उपजो, नाम सुने सब विघ्न तरे। आन विधाता बैठे आसन, इंद्र अप्सरा नृत्य करे। देखत वेद ब्रह्मा जी की जाको, विघ्न विनाशन नाम धरे। एक दंत गज बदन विनायक, त्रिनयन रूप अनूप धरे। पग खंबा से उदर पुष्ट है, देख चंद्रमा हास्य करे। देशाप कृष्णि देव को, देशाप श्री चंद्र देव को। कलाहीन तत्काल करे। चौदह लोक में फिरे गणपति, तीन भुवन में राज करे। उत प्रभात जब आरती गावे, जाके सिर यश छत्र फिरे। गणपति की पूजा पहले करनी, काम सभी निर्विघ्न करे। श्री प्रताप गणपति जी की, कर जोर स्तुति करे। गणपति सेवा मंगल मेवा, सेवा से सब विघ्न तरे। सेवा से सब विघ्न तरे। ओम एकदंताय विद्महि वक्रतुंडाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ति प्रचोदयात्। ओम श्री विघ्नेश्वराय नमो नमः। बोले श्री गजानन स्वामी की जय। भज जय गणेश गण नाथ दयानिधि, सकल विघ्न कर दूर हमारे। जय गणेश गण नाथ दयानिधि, सकल विघ्न कर दूर हमारे। प्रथम धरे जो ध्यान तुम्हारो, ध्यान तुम्हारो, तिसके पूरन कारज सारे। ल लंबो डरे गज लंबो डरे गज बदन मनोहर करिए त्रिशूल परेशोवर धारे जय गणेश गण रिधि सिधि दो चमर दुलावे चमर दुलावे मूषक वाहन परम सुखारे ब्रह्म देक सुर ब्रह्म सुर ध्यावत मन में ऋषि मुनि गण सब दास तुम्हारे ब्रह्मानंद सहाय करो नित सहाय करो नित भक्त जनों के तुम रखवारे ब्रह्मानंद सन ब्रह्मानंद सन आये करो नित भक्त जनों के तुम रखवारे जय गणेश गण सकल विघन कर दूर हमारे दूर हमारे दूर हमारे सकल विघन कर दूर हमारे जय गणेश गण जय गणेश गण नाथ दयानिधि सकल विघ्न कर दूर हमारे सकल विघ्न कर दूर हमारे जय गणेश
बोले श्री गजानन स्वामी की डिवोटीज देयर आर मेनी वेरिंग अकाउंट्स अबाउट द अपीयरेंस ऑफ लॉर्ड गणेश आई शैल गिव यू वन आई मीन द फॉलोइंग नाइट्स वी शैल डेल्व इनटू द अदर्स So devotees, what happened? There are two followers of Ma Parvati, Jaya and Vijaya. So they looked very closely and out of love for Ma Parvati, they realized that she was always surrounded by the followers and the attendants of Lord Shiva. And she had none of her own. And they were very particular about having their privacy and time for themselves. And so they approached Ma Parvati. And they explained the situation to her. At first she said, That's my husband Shivaji. And if he is offering that kind of protection and have these followers of his around me, then what is wrong in that? It's something good. It shows he cares. But then they said, Ma, you know as much as we know that we ladies, there are certain things about us that only we should be aware of and indulge in, and not have the followers of Shiva, nor even Nandi, and others around us. We need our time, our space, we need our privacy. Devotees, Ma Parvati agreed. And so what she did? Aisa vichar kar. Parvati ji ne apne sharir ki mail se sarv lakshan sampan ek purush ka nirman kiya. Vah sharir ke sab abhyayon se nirdosh to tha ki kintu sundar vishar aur sarv shobha sampan tatha mahabali evam parakrami tha. पार्वती जी ने उस अनेक प्रकार के वस्त्रों से सजा अनेक प्रकार के लंकारों से युक्त कर बड़ा आशीर्वाद दिया और कहा कि तुम ही एकमात्र मेरे पुत्र हो, दूसरा कोई नहीं। तब उस पुत्र ने पार्वती से कहा कि माँ, मेरे लिए क्या आज्ञा है? क्या आज्ञा है? मैं आपकी सब आज्ञाओं को पूर्ण करूंगा। पार्वती माँ ने कहा कि पुत्र, तुम मेरे द्वार के रक्षक रहो, मेरी आज्ञा के बिना कोई कैसा भी क्यों न हो मेरे घर के भीतर न आने पावे, कितना भी कोई हक क्यों न करे, तुम उसे न आने देना। ऐसा कहकर पार्वती जी ने गणेश जी के हाथों में एक लकड़ी दे दी और प्रेम से मुख चुम कर द्वार पर बिठा दिया। वह लकड़ी वे गणेश जी माता के हिता द्वार पर जा बैठे। तब पार्वती जी फिर जाकर स्नान करने लगी। उसी समय भगवान शिव फिर द्वार पर आ गए और जब अंदर जाने लगी तब शिव जी ने न जानकर गणेश्वर ने कहा कि मेरे माता की आज्ञा से बिना आप नहीं जा सकते। माता इस समय स्नान कर रही है, तुम कहां जाते हो? यहां से चले जाओ। यह कहकर गणेश जी लकड़ी ले रोक लिया। भगवान शिव ने कहा, अरे मूर्ख, तू किसको रोकता है? क्या मुझे नहीं जानता कि मैं शिव हूं? यह सुनते ही गणेश ने महेश्वर पर लकड़ी से प्रहार कर दिया। इस प्रकार महेश्वर ने क्रूर होकर कहा, अरे बालक, तू मूर्ख है, क्या नहीं जानता है कि मैं गिरिजापति शंकर हूं? अरे बालक, मैं अपने ही घर में जाता हूं, तू मुझे क्यों रोकता है? ऐसा कह जब गणेश की परवाह न कर शिव जी फिर भीतर जाने लगे तो गणेश जी ने फिर उन पर लकड़ी का प्रहार कर दिया। इस पर शिव जी ने क्रूर हा अपने गणों को आज्ञा दे दी कि इसको रोको। ऐसा कह भगवान शिव बाहर ही स्थित रहे, अद्भुत लीलाधारी संसार की अपनी लीला दिखाने लगी। बोले श्री गजानन स्वामी की। डिवोटीज, it's a long incident, I shall appreciate it. So Ma decides to act upon the suggestion of these two individuals, Jaya and Vijaya. They made sense. So from her own body, you know, there are many things one would rub before taking a bath. Ma would rub the turmeric, the haldi, then all kinds of oils and so on. And so Ma Parvati took some of that. And she made it into the form of a child, a boy, and infused life into it. And so, very beautiful to behold. She decorated with him with all kinds of ornaments. And then he said, Ma, she said, I am, you now are my son. He said, Ma, then what do you want me to do? What should I do since I am your son? She said, oh son, Stay at the doorway. I'm going to bid. Allow no one to enter. Is that all? Yes, my son. Do this. And she gave him a stick. A lakri. So he took the stick. He went by the door. And he's sitting there as the door is closed. And Ma Parvati inside is doing snanam. Bathing. As it so happened, Bhagwan Shankar came. He was unaware of the creation of Lord Ganesh by Goddess Parvati. So when he tried to enter, Ganesh stood up very manfully, very powerfully. He raised a stick and said, "Who are you? And where do you think you are going? You cannot go inside. I have instructions to prevent anyone from entering this house." So he was taken aback, that is Shivaji. He said, "Don't you know? I am Shiva." But Ganesh Baba, now this is just how the story goes from the worldly point of view. We'll explain in a while. That didn't matter to him. "You are Shiva." He said, "You cannot go. I have instruction from my mother, and my mother is Parvati." Then he said, "Well, I am the husband of Parvati." He said, "You cannot go. That said Parvati, you are claiming you are the husband of her. She said, told, she herself told me, and allow none to enter. You cannot go." And so devotees, one is saying, "I want to go." The other one said, "No." And so what happened? A battle broke out. And so, to go into cut that whole story short, the followers of Shivaji came in their numbers. The followers of Vishnu came. And they all came, and Ganesh Baba was outnumbered. And the rigid, it was so bad, they reached a stage where he was decapitated. His head was taken off from his body. And when that happened, devotees, by now Divine Mother Parvati had finished her bath. And she's hearing all this commotion. What they were doing now? After taking advantage of that child and beheading him, they were clapping, singing, and dancing. So she found, what is this all about? When she came out, is what nobody would like to see. "Your dear child you created a short while ago is on the ground without a head." Without a head. Devotees, she couldn't take that. And she shakti, the energy, power, Mahabhadra Kali Kankali. In a twinkling of an eye, she created thousands of powerful Kalis like herself. And she gave them an instruction, "Go and destroy them." So devotees, another battle started. But the followers of Shiva and Vishnu were no match for Shakti Ma. Nobody's a match for Ma devotees. She is the source of power. Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva get their power and everything they have from Ma. And so when Brahma and Vishnu and Shiva saw that the followers were being decimated, then they decided, "You know what? It's time for conversation. It's time for dialogue. Otherwise, all of us will be destroyed." And they went. I'm just giving you the gist of it, leaving out many important details. And out of that, they sought forgiveness. And Ma said, "You gave me pain, and you want me to give you happiness? That doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. You can't make me unhappy and expect me to make you happy. If you want peace and you want happiness, bring my son back to life. That's all I will accept." And so devotees, again cutting it short, the decision was taken to find whatever it is. And so they were sent in search. And what was the search for? Any animal, any creature, the first one they should find, they should behead that. Now, you may have heard other places that any creature where the mother is sleeping, the back turned to the child. But it's not written here, so I can't say that, but we heard that before. But they said, "Go and the first creature you see, whatever it might be, behead it and bring that head. And we shall put it up on the body of Ganesh. We shall restore him back to life." It so happened it was an elephant. And so devotees, that elephant was beheaded. The head was brought. And life was injected into that head of the body of Ganesh, and he came back to life. And there was merriment, gaiety, festivity, and celebration. So what is this story all about? Just a few words, devotees. Mother Parvati on her own created Ganesh. We're using the word Ganesh because we know that name. But devotees, at that point in time, he was not Ganesh or Gajanan or Gajamukh or Gajahast. You know what his name was? His name was Nayakin Vina. Or put it the other way, Vinayak. And what does Vinayak mean? He who is created without the presence of a male. Now we know it's male and female come together to bring forth a child, whether it's male or female child. But in this case, it was Parvati Ma who did this of her own. So she had actually gone against her own, the old way of Prakriti and Purush, male and female. Now it's a whole big wonderful field, but I'm just sharing it briefly. So he was Vinayak. He came with all the intervention of a male. And so devotees, that could not remain as it was. It was like an aberration. And so this is where the elephant head came in. Now we're going a little further again. Devotees, Shiva enters. When I say entered in the story, and he wants to enter the home. This is all the plan of the Lord. So when Ganesh, well Vinayak, stood up and refused Shivaji to enter, he was showing egoism and pride, although he was following the instruction of his mother. But then he was told that, I am the father, I'm the husband. So if you know I'm the husband of Parvati and you're the son of Parvati, does that not mean that I am your father? And you're standing up to me and you're denying me entrance? You have such egoism in you, such pride in you. And wherever there's egoism and pride, it has to be removed. And that's how the head was removed. The head of Vinayak. And the elephant head came, and so became Ganesh. So understand what's happening here, devotees. This is very good to know. So, the removal of that head of the child is really the removal of the ego of man, the pride of man. And it leads to an elevation, a heightened consciousness, to transformation into a superior being. And indeed he was. And he became a superior being. Devotees. So those are some little points I thought I will share with you. There is so much more. Now many will question, why was the elephant placed? And the answer is very simple. They told him, or they told the follower, the first creature you see, behead that and bring the head. And devotees, it so happened it was an elephant. But why? Who was this elephant? The Puran tells us there's a river called Pushpabhadra. And there a herd of elephants used to live. And devotees, they were told to go to the north. Why were they told to go to the north? Because according to directions, the north is associated with wisdom. The south is associated with depth. The east is associated with intellectual capability and capacity. And the west is associated with that which is declining. Directions. Very important in Hinduism. So they were told to go to the north, which is associated with wisdom. And who is Ganesh Baba? Ganapati Baba. He's the god of wisdom. So there on the bank of this river, there were this herd of elephants. And there they were enjoying themselves. And so devotees, when the devatas went, this was the first being or creature they saw. And they beheaded it. Who was that creature besides being an elephant? It was a Gandharva. A Gandharva is a celestial musician, singer, dancer. These are celestial people. And this one is not mentioned in detail. But he had done something to fall from grace or to fall into disgrace. When someone is in a high position, when someone is in heaven, we say, if someone has elevated himself and he degrades himself, he falls, and he falls very hard. I'm not only those forms of punishment. Yeah, I use the word punishment guardedly. It's to go into the animal world, the animal kingdom. But you have almost no rights. And so devotees, he had done something wrong. And from that lofty status, Gandhara, residing in the heavenly region, a celestial singer, musician, and dancer for the entertainment and amusement of the gods and goddesses, there he now had to eat grass with other elephants in Pushpabhadra like an ordinary being. And so he was crying and every day waiting, when will I be free? I do not want to be an elephant. I cannot continue in this way. I want release. I want freedom. I want liberation. I don't want bondage. I've experienced the taste of freedom. I've experienced the taste of happiness. But now I'm not happy. And so his prayer was not being answered when the devatas were sent. The followers of Shivaji were sent to bring whatever creature is so happened to be the head of this elephant who was a Gandhar. It all ties in beautifully, doesn't it? So this is what it's all about, devotees. So when the head was brought, what is God? God is a giver of life. They recited Vedic mantras, sprinkled the water, placed the head, and but we had a sin of Ganesh, we can't say Vinayak now. Ganapati Baba jumped on his feet. And devotees, when his mother saw him so lively and full of zest and zeal, she hugged him and kissed him. And tomorrow we'll hear what happened thereafter. There are many, many wonderful things you still have to hear. And devotees, there are many things you will hear that you never heard before. I'm no expert. I'm just reading the books, picking out what is relevant parts, and I'll share them very briefly and very, very effectively and meaningfully for you. Now, I was thinking, why is Ganesh Baba so special? What is his contribution to world civilization? What has he done that is his celebrations are now so marked, so worldwide, everywhere you think of it, devotees. And not only Hindus, non-Hindus, you go in those various places where they sell souvenirs and so on. They like the elephant. There's, I know of some people, every part of the house is some kind of elephant toy or whatever material. I can't go into all of that. When I say every part, I mean every part. Even from keychain, even from the where they hang around the neck, the chain, and even the ring, everywhere is elephant, 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 elephant. Elephant stands for auspiciousness. Elephant stands for a new beginning. Elephant stands for Ganesh. Elephant represents wisdom. And isn't this what we all want in life? Isn't this what we want, devotees? So, in addition to that, and this is what I'm going to be doing in a year again, to show you. Because I ask myself, I'm not speaking, egoistically. Why elephant? I mean, we explain why from the story point of view. But there are many things very special about the elephant. And here is one of them, devotees. Wisdom. The elephant, it was beheaded, we know that. Devotees, there's what we call organ transplant. Where you could take out a man's heart, repair it, put it back in. You could have got a man's kidney, well, you could have disposed of it or whatever you want. Devotees, they have now reached a stage. We talk about decapitation in the medical field. It is now soon they're reaching a stage where they can attach a head to the body. But it happened before. There was a girl who was born with certain problems, and devotee, she became old. And the situation was she couldn't look right, nor left, nor up, nor down. She had to look straight. Now that's a good thing, eh? If we all learn to look, always look straight. We'll go straight, right? If you look straight, you go straight. So this was her problem. But it could be difficult too. It could be very, very, challenging for her. So devotees, believe it or not, medical science, they were able, I won't say to decapitate her, but they were able to do the operation in such a way that they were able to separate the head
not totally, but quite a good way from the body. They put a plate, you know, steel plate, and they put four screws and they fix it. And now she could look right, left, up, down, and anyhow you want her to look. This is what they have done so far. Where is this coming from? When we have organ transplant, where did it come from? All of these things are coming from the scriptures which the wise ones have gone into. Why everywhere throughout the history of human civilization, they're looking for what? They say they're going east for what? Gold, for spice, for silver, and all that's nice. Devotees is much, much more they came up with. And they study the scriptures. The first people who translated our scriptures were the Germans. The Germans translated our scriptures, and that's where they got the swastika from. And swastika is the auspicious sign, but they use it in a bad way. And swastika is a symbol of Lord Ganesh. I can go on and on, devotees. But I never promise. I'm sorry. I know it sounds like a politician. And right now, I don't want to be one of that. I don't think anybody wants one of them to hear one of them. Anyway, that's your choice. I'm saying to you, there is so much to share about Ganapati Baba as the elephant-headed god. I use the term they use loosely, but you and I know he is our Lord, our Ganapati, our Divine Father. And so, devotees, let us join once again, do a kirtanam, and then we conclude. Throughout the yagya, keep your focus upon Lord Ganesh. Devotees, he has inspired man now to go towards head transplant. Man has already done heart transplant and other areas and organs of the body. The last has become the head transplant. And we'll speak more about the head and the heart in connection to the soul, if not tomorrow, some other time. And you will be surprised at what is taking place, devotees. I could give you a hint. If you all, and I know you all are computer literate, go and get a view of the head, the skull, minus all the skin and all these wonderful things. A view from below. And what will you see when you look up? You'll be shocked. And I'll bring the picture to show you too. But right now, let's pray to Lord Ganesh. There are many things he has helped so many before. He has inspired man. He is changing, creating a revolution in this world. And that's why everywhere he's being worshipped. And let's continue to worship him, whether we know what he stands for, we didn't stand for. The fact is, we love him. We are captivated by his presence, by his form. And let us therefore continue to so do. And with the passing of time, by our love of him and service to him, he'll begin to open our minds, our intellects, and become more receptive and more loving towards him. And there is nothing that he cannot do, devotees. The greatest sins, the greatest mistakes, whatever it might be, can be overcome. And right knowledge, sarsar vid bhavati, right knowledge comes for transformation in life. And this is the occasion. This is Ganesh Jayanti. And it's today he came, he was created by Goddess Parvati, and then he became, from Vinayak, he became Ganapati. Remember, Vinayak created without the intervention of a male. So devotees, and the head had to be removed because it represents ego. And what removes ego? Shivaji. And what is Shiva? Vairagya. If we have spiritual dispassion, we give up that which is detrimental and hold on to that which is developmental. We know what tyag is, and not holding on, then we can destroy the ego. Because the ego wants us to grasp. The ego wants us to hold on to desire and so much more. And then devotees, we have Shakti or energy. Ma was there to teach us how important she is in the form of Durga, Lakshmi, Saraswati. Gyan Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Ichha Shakti. Willpower, right knowledge, right action will bring transformation. We glorify Lord Ganesh. Let's join the body.
Mahaganapati namostu te, bolo Mahaganapati namostu te, Mahaganapati.
The elephant face one. He's the son of Shiva and Parvati. Not one, but both of them.
Parvati Nandana Namostute.
Parvati Nandana
Namostute. Shri Priya Nandana Namostute.
Shri Priya Nandana Namostute.
He Girija Sutta Namostute.
These are forms of man, and he's the son of all of these. He sees them as mother, he respects them as mother, he loves them as mother, and he serves them as mother. Look at how he lost his head looking from the purely literal point of view, but he never went back on the word he gave to his mother. You can look at his story in so many ways. He could have said, you know what, I'm outnumbered, I'm not going to follow instruction of my mother. I chose this thing and I go. My mother says, stand guard, I will stand strong. My mother says, stay here, I will stand strong. My mother said, allow none to come, I will so do. Because my mother, she made me, she loved me, she kissed me on my forehead, she hugged me. Devotees, how can you forget ma? How can you not serve her? How can you look after her? Even though the opposition is strong, if the situation is terrible and trying and difficult, this story can be taken in so many levels, devotees. I'm trying in a simple way, in a short time. Let us remember this simple point, devotees.
Hey, Girija Sutta Namostute.
Girija Sutta Namostute.
Jai Girija Sutta Namostute.
Parvati Nandana Namostute. Parvati Nandana Namostute.
Shri Priya Nandana Namostute.
Shri Priya Nandana Namostute.
Omkarishwar Namostute.
With a horse face, playing tabla or drum. Who is he? Why? We all know what the rat is about. And there's so much more about the rat we also hear. And Ganapati Baba is standing or sitting in all his glory. He's looking at you and looking at I, but more importantly, he's inside us. He's in our hearts, in the form of the soul. Where is the soul? In our hearts. So devotees, he knows what is taking place. He knows what we need. And therefore it's up to you and I to serve him, to love him, to bow down to him, to think of him. And now is the time, this is the place, and this is the opportunity, and this is Ganesh Jayanti, Ganesh Kosav.
Jai, jai, jai.
Parvati and stop. You must include Pita Mahadeva. That's the Prakriti and Purush. A word and its meaning. The substance, the form and substance, and so much more. This was all about devotees. Shiva and Parvati.
Mata Parvati Pita Mahadeva. Gajanana He Ganapati Deva. Gauri Ganesh, Uma Mahesh, Parvati Nandan Siddhi Ganesh, Gauri Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh, Bolo Sharanam Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh,
Sharanam Ganesh, Sharanam Ganesh,
Shivanandana Ganapati Ganesh,
Shivanandana,
oh Shivanandana Ganapati Ganesh, Gauri Ganesh, Uma Mahesh, Parvati Nandan Siddhi Ganesh.
Bole Shri Gajanan Swami Ki.
Dhyan Tumhari Prathme Darejo. Dhyan Tumhari Tiske Puran Karaj Sara. Tiske
Puran Karaj Sara. Jai Ganesh Ganapati Dayani Sakal Vighn Kare Dur Hamare. Jai Shri Ganesh.
Gaj Varnu Manohare Lambodar Gaj Varnu Manohare Karitrishuva Parishuvar Dare
Karitrishuva Parishuvar Dare Jai Ganesh Ganapati.
जय 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 गणनायका जय जय विघ्न विनाशका जय शुभ मंगल गजवदना
Friend.